Snake Eyes G.I. Joe Origins. Hey, what's up, guys? It's Josh here. Today I want to do a little movie review on a movie called Snake Eyes from 2021, and it's like a G.I. Joe origin story. Now, I never really played with G.I. Joes as a kid. I don't really know any of the terminology. I don't know if it was a show. I know they did a couple movies back in the day, but I was going over to my buddy's house and we were looking for some action movies to put on, and we watched the trailer for Snake Eyes and we're like, let's put this one on. And I knew something was up about this movie because the trailer looked really interesting and really good, and then it was rated so poorly on IMDb, like wow, I think it was like a 5.5, which means it just really was trash, kind of. So I don't know how the trailer could show such good action, but then it'd be that much of a letdown. I gotta check it out. The story is like this origin story of Snake Eyes, and I guess he's in the G.I. Joe universe. I don't really know if he's a good guy or a bad guy. I assume he's a bad guy, but I could be completely wrong. Snake Eyes' dad gets killed in like the very beginning scene, and that kind of stirs something up inside him, and then they cut several years later, and there's like several groups of people, the Yakuza, other groups of people, good, bad. So he's kind of getting mixed in with all these as he's figuring out, you know, who he is as Snake Eyes. All right, guys, let's jump into the pros of this movie. The pros is that it had a few good action sequences, and I would say also that the last 30 minutes or so were okay. It definitely took a while to wind up and really get you engaged. I actually thought that they were gonna kind of throw this whole movie away, or it was just really not gonna hit, but by the end, things did crank up a bit. I did appreciate some of the action sequences, and I just overall liked the ending a lot better. It did have some high quality action, especially you look in that trailer, it has to have some action. So there was some good action, and I did like the end, but unfortunately, that's where the pros end. All right, guys, let's jump into the cons of this movie. The cons is that Snake Eyes in this movie is kind of a joke. I think they kept him in this ineffective stage for too long in the movie. I mean, obviously, if you have somebody starting from the bottom and going to the top, they need to have some challenges. You know, they're not gonna just be the best right away at the beginning, but I just felt like for most of this movie, Snake Eyes is kind of like a failure. He's kind of just like a loser. Other people are much more respectable, much more serious, much more strong than him, pretty much the whole movie. So it was kind of hard to even get behind Snake Eyes for that reason. And then another con was like really close up Jason Bourne style action scenes. Now, I think a lot of other people are gonna complain about this, but it's these really, really close up jump shots, and you're seeing a bunch of stuff. And I think it was really good when it first came out because it was a little unique. It almost felt like you're seeing this aggressive fight, but nowadays it's just really cheap and you can't see anything. So a lot of the action scenes were just thrown away just because of that. And then the last con I had was that it should have been about 20 minutes shorter. It was about 2 hours. This movie really, really dragged. It felt like it didn't even have like almost a story at all. Like technically it does, but I felt like I was just seeing random scenes with just the hint of story in the background. And if you're really paying attention, you could kind of piece something together, but it wasn't like a story you could just understand right away. 20 minutes would just help with that extra length. It would help Snake Eyes, you know, get to where he needs to be faster. Because this had probably a decent budget, usually the higher the budget, the more scenes they shoot, and when they have more scenes, the more they want to put in the film to make it 2 hours. So anyways, guys, should you own, stream, or pass this movie? I would go with a hard pass personally, but did you enjoy this movie? Was there some redeeming aspects that you found with it? Again, I did enjoy the ending, but overall, this was just a kind of a big waste of time. I really did like the ending of this movie. Just everything else just completely fell flat. But what did you think? Am I right? Am I wrong? Did you like Snake Eyes? Did you like the old G.I. Joes? I actually looked up the old G.I. Joe movies and they're rated pretty poorly as well. So I don't know how much better they're gonna be. But anyways, guys, thank you guys so, so much for watching this video. It means so, so much to me. You guys are the best. I'm having a great day out here. Hopefully having a great day at home. See you all in the next video. Peace.